Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Today I'm going to do a riff on a chicken curry. Around 2006, the end of 2006, beginning of 2007, Julie and I took a trip through India. We started in the southernmost part of India and took the train along the western coast all the way up north to Amritsar. And we were in India for 3.5 or 4 months. And during that time, we traveled by train. And so we'd spend a couple of weeks in different spots. And we were just exploring and eating. We had no plan of where we were going to go and what we were going to see. We would just stop along the way. And I would go into kitchens. And I spent a lot of time in kitchens trying to figure out what the different flavors were. And as we traveled from south to north, the flavors changed. The dishes morphed. It was very interesting to me. And this is my take on sort of a northern India, almost a Punjabi kind of thing, of a chicken curry. So in this pot, I put some vegetable oil. So the oil is good and hot. In first, I'm going to put in some cumin. Then I'm going to put in some cloves, some green cardamom, and a black cardamom. And I'm just going to swirl these around to get them toasted. And the toasting will not take long. On top of that, I'm going to add a piece of cinnamon and some bay leaves. Okay, we're good. Next in, some chopped onion. And so I'm just going to stir these onions around in the pan over kind of a medium-high heat with the spices so that they infuse with the spices and they start to brown and caramelize. If your heat is too high, the onions will burn and they'll get bitter, and you don't want that to happen. You also don't want to burn the spices because, again, they'll get bitter and you don't want that to happen. And one of the spices in here is black cardamom. And I find it to be a very interesting spice. Completely different flavor profile from green cardamom. And I have videos on both of those, and I'll try to remember to link to them below. But you can find those videos elsewhere on the channel. Now, into this small food processor. I'm going to put some ginger and garlic. And just a couple of spoonfuls of the tomato liquid just to kind of get it lubricated. And I'm going to put the lid on and we're going to turn that to mush. Now, one of the places we visited was an onion farm in the state of Gujarat. He was an onion farmer who also had a poultry operation, and I'll stick some photos up about that. And I learned a couple of things on this onion farm. I learned that a lot of Indian chefs prefer tiny little onions like this rather than the big onions that we normally get here in North America. Something about the flavor of a smaller onion and the lack of moisture in a smaller onion. I don't remember exactly. It was a while ago, 2006, 2007. And it may have just been a very specific variety that was grown in India that had this smaller size and also had that flavor profile. Completely lost on me at this point, but I tried to get really small onions to use. I also learned that don't rush the browning process on the onions. Take it low, take it slow, get them nice and caramelized, and really build that onion flavor. And I think we're almost there. And I usually cut it too short because I do get impatient. So now it's time to put in the ginger and garlic paste. And we just want to fry that with the onions until most of the moisture is gone. So just swirl that around in the pan, and that's not going to take long at all. I'm also going to add in the dry spices now. So this is coriander that I have just sort of roughly crushed. This is garam masala, which is a spice mix. Chili powder. And turmeric. Where I'm also going to add in the tomatoes. So I should be using fresh tomatoes. I don't have any left in the garden, so I'm going to use canned tomatoes. And I'm going to take probably about half of this can, and these are whole tomatoes, and a little bit of the juice. The rest of those tomatoes will end up in another dish I'm making today as well for supper. So put those in, stir them around, and chili peppers. These are not the correct chili peppers, but I'm going to put them in anyway because that's what I have. And I'm just crushing them with my fingers just to start to release some oil. And in they go as well. I've also got this one completely completely not the right chili pepper, but it was left over from last night's supper. In it goes. Okay, a little bit of salt. And this is where we put in the chicken. So I have skinless chicken thighs, but there's still bones inside. So I'm gonna put those in. And it's gonna need a little bit of liquid. So I have here some water mixed with chicken stock. Now I'm using a mix of chicken stock and water because I had a little bit of chicken stock left over from another recipe. I had it sitting in the fridge. I needed to use it up, so I thought I'd use it here. I never saw anyone in India cooking this dish with chicken stock. It was always cooked with water. So you just want to bring up the level in the pot so that there's enough liquid to cover the chicken. Okay, so as this comes to a simmer, I'm going to add just a little bit more liquid. I'm going to put a lid on it. And I'm going to stick this in the oven. Traditionally, this would probably be cooked on a stovetop. I find for something like this that I'm going to cook for a couple hours, putting it in the oven, there's more even heat, and you don't have to worry about it burning on the bottom because the heat is coming from all around. So into the oven, 300 degrees. I'm going to leave that for two and a half, maybe 3 hours till the chicken is done and the sauce has come together nicely. Okay, it is time for chicken curry, or a version of chicken curry. So we've got some basmati rice going in our ancient,
Working.
Still works. It is actually amazing that it still works. It's fantastic. Okay, let's scoop some of this out. Oh, that looks really good. Smells fantastic.
You want to? I was going to put a little sauce on that. Actually, okay.
There you go.
Say it on the right there. Thank you.
There you go. Get some too. And a fork for you.
Thank you.
So we've got some naan. We've got some chana masala that we made and a cauliflower with ginger.
This will all go together.
This will all go together really well. Okay.
That's one of the fun things that I really love about Indian food is that each has its own flavor, but then you mix them all and they all taste really good together, right? So you've got so many flavors.
So this is really good. One of the things that usually keeps me from cooking Indian food is that I always think it takes too long. That really, if you want to do it properly, you need a slow simmered sauce. But this came together relatively quickly. And especially since I could use the oven, I would just make something and shove it in the oven. It goes for 2 or 3 hours. You don't have to think about it. And you can move on to the next thing. So this took probably everything about 3.5 hours from start to finish.
That's not bad for time-wise.
Time-wise, which and it's really flavorful. So don't be afraid to cook Indian food at home. Don't be afraid if you think you're not doing it properly because it's still going to taste amazing.
Yes.
Give it a try. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.